In this special year, 1426, the Dominican wrote his beautiful verses, De Visione Dei, the Vision of God, which are about the love of God and the bliss of human nature. Scholars from all over the world think that this work belongs to the most outstanding lines ever written during the entire period of the German mystical tradition, which extended from the early 11th century until the so-called harvest of the Middle Ages in the late 15th century. Kurt Flasch is of the opinion that the language in De Visione Dei is singular and poetic, that Cusanus never wrote anything else as perfect, and that this book, which occupies the pinnacle of his chef d'oeuvre, is a masterpiece of medieval literature. Why is this work, in contrast to others, considered so outstanding, and why has it retained its attractiveness over the centuries? Why was it chosen over a multitude of other praises of God that are perhaps even more congenial and of which the German mystical tradition is so full of? And how is it possible at all that the plain work of theology, the vision of a medieval scholar, remains a benchmark even in the superficial consciousness of the European research business? Cusanus tells us, in short, about the mutuality of love and understanding. It depends on the point of view, either the look of God or the look of mankind. While God and his creation look at each other, mirror each other, and enjoy the lust of being looked at, they share the mutual love in which they dwell. Mein Herz ruht nicht, o Herr, weil deine Liebe es mit solcher Sehnsucht entflammt hat, dass es nur in dir ruhen kann. Dein Lieben ist dein Sehen, deine Vatergüte ist dein Schauen, das uns alle väterlich umfasst, denn wir sagen Vater unser. Die Liebe des Vaters kommt aber der Kinder zuvor. Solange wir deine Kinder sind und dich als Kinder anschauen, hörst du auch nicht auf, uns mit väterlichem Blick anzuschauen. Dein Sehen ist Vorsehung. The human being in the biblical text of Genesis is essentially an image of God and comes into existence as his likeness. Cusanus sees it as a relationship similar to that existing between a loving father and his son. This so-called procedere ut imago, of which Flasch talks, to proceed in existence like an image, as a model of human existence in general, is a so-called theologumenon. It means a standard view of theology. When the source of being, God, is identical with human nature, the notion of mirror stands for an intimate complicity. This intimate complicity is explained as being an experience of immediate recognition and thus one of joy and expectation. Cusanus describes it with the words, Mein Herz ruht nicht, my heart cannot find rest. In short, the notion of mirror describes a relation, whereas the notion of image describes an entity or, in the words of Leibniz, a kind of monad. Therefore, it is not surprising that mystical speculation about love recurs far more often on the notion of mirror than it does on image, because the mirror exemplifies the dynamic of a mutual relation, not the essence of an image which is much more static and self-contained. Love, as the main relation in human culture, is closely connected with the philosophy of the mirror, or with the mirror as a philosophic concept. When it comes to love, the eyes of the lovers mirror each other, and this may well be where das Heilige im Alltagsleben, a sparkle of the sacred within our everyday life, may occur.